What's up, everybody? It's Nerp here, and welcome to my kind of ESL wrap-up kind of video. So, Sunday, July 26th, was the 2014 Order All-Stars ESL Cup. There is going to be one for every other faction and one Highlander Cup in the coming weeks, and I'm planning on participating in all of them if I can. And I recorded all my matches from the Order Cup, and they will be in this video. I'm incredibly sorry I wasn't able to do a live commentary of them, but I just wasn't in a situation where I could. But I did record them, so I can do a post-commentary, and I can analyze my plays and stuff. I'm not gonna, leave any, make you guys find out what happens. Mostly probably already know. Antirad won the tournament. I came in third place. I lost in the semifinals to Zark, and I won the match for third place after that. So third place isn't bad, and I want to do well in these five tournaments because I want to get the prize of... There's gold prize, which I don't really care about, but then you can get an exclusive avatar head, which I just missed out in the 2013 All-Star Series. I was like, you need to top four at the end of the All-Star Series. And I was number 5 or number 6. So I just missed out on that one. Hopefully this one, we're off to a good start at number 3. With Antirad and Zark ahead of us. So, the way ESL works, if you don't know, is... the way this ESL works was... your deck has to be only order. So, no splash of any colors. Just order versus order. A lot of mirror matches. Some people did aggro order, some people did structure order, which didn't really work that well. But it seemed like the aggro order was doing the best, and the problem with that is sometimes it leads to a lot of luck, because mirror matches do involve a lot of luck. But I tried to craft my deck so it would give me the best chance to win against another order deck, another deck like itself. So this is what I came up with. It is very similar to a normal aggro order deck I play in ranked myself. I have... Key differences is I have, first of all, I have Spearmen. I have 2 Royal Spearmen and 3 Ducal Spearmen. Since Order only range unit is, besides Bangano, is Crosswoman, I thought the Royal Spearmen and Ducal Spearmen would be very good, and they did turn out pretty well in the match. Notably absent is Wings Captain. I always thought Wings Captain wasn't really that good ever since the nerf to 3 attack, and I think that it was good they didn't use Wings Captain, because to make up for that, I put in 2 transpositions. That also gives me extra moves, so it kind of makes up for the fact that there's no Wings Captains, and those actually were really key in my games. To put those 2 transpositions in, I took out a POV there and a flip. And then lastly, there is 1 reversal in place of, what did I put this in for? The Wings Cleaver. There was a reversal. The reason for this is because on a row with Wings Warder, you can't really bother the Wing Shield and stuff, so I thought this would come in handy, but it didn't really do much for me. So this I kind of regret. I kind of wish I had an extra pother flip instead of this reversal. And notably, there was also no decimations. I figure in order versus order, mirror match, a lot of times I'm facing aggro order, and it's just going to be trying to, beat down the idols as fast as possible. And you're not going to have time to just sit around sacking for scrolls and drawing decimations, because by then the other person's just going to wipe out your board. But I definitely have examples of that happening in the matches you'll see in this video. So this is the deck for a quick comparison of my regular ranked aggro order deck. That's the difference, if you want to compare them. I basically went over all the differences, though. But it was pretty standard. Here, you could see the final bracket on your screen right now. My blue path is highlighted. See, I got a bye in the round of 32, because we didn't have a full 32 people, and I was pretty high-seeded because I have played well in other past ESL tournaments. And I beat in round of 32, round of 16 are best of 1, quarters and semis are best of 3, and so is the match for third place is best of three, and then finals is best of five. So that's what happened. I beat Castro best of one, beat DeVirui two in a row, and losses are 2-3. So now you'll see the matches, you can analyze my plays, and yeah. So this match was really, really, really good. This first match between me and Castro, well, we only had one match. But he got to a good start because he went first. And I have a pretty good hand. I have two skirmishers and everything. And I am just hoping I can punish him, but there's nothing I can really do. And he's running pushback, which is quite a interesting scroll in the mirror, because it does sacrifice some tempo for yourself, but it really stops the opponent if they have like a big creature on the board that's like really strong with enchantments. And I'm trying to make my way back into the game with skirmishers. And this may have been he has a big like lead like on the board control, and here's where I put transposition to work. Ta-da! So that's wiped. But he does punish me with a blessing of haste, I believe. It was interesting to see what scrolls people had in their decks, because many decks were not like mine. Like, people were running, a lot of people were running purification and pushback, which is pretty good. Some people are running interesting stuff like Warding Stone and Waking Stones and stuff like that. But that's more of like the structure decks. So I almost lost this match. I mean, you know I win it because it's best of one. And I made it past the round of 16. Remember, I got a bye in the first round, so I waited for Cash Flow to beat, I forgot who was facing in the round of 32. And then I faced the winner of that match. So you see the spike unit in front is being good protector there. The 4 health is really nice. Dukal Spearman would be so good. I'd probably use it in ranked if it had one extra attack. If it just had 2 attack, that would be awesome. I believe it used to have 2 attack like way long ago, but they changed it to 1. So Eternal Sword, and that thing is pretty scary because when you break that, the Eternal Sword lashes onto other stuff. Oh, by the way, a little note to mention: you should all use Ugster's betting booth to bet on which guild will win the ESL. Because I made myself 2,000 gold, or actually no, I made myself 1,000 gold because I put in 1,000 gold on the badge. A person from the Badger Guild will win, and I won. So then I was given back 2,000. So I basically had a 1,000 gold profit because my guild won, and that was Anti-Rad coming through in the end. And we also had our guild coming in third place, so that was me too. Many people chose Strategic Angels to win. But this game is really good. Like, it gets even closer after this. I know it's going really fast in the background, but that's because I have to fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 matches in this video. So I think this is probably the longest match. You see we're just exchanging punch for punch. I'm getting pretty decent draws. Like, I wish I had like an attack buff here so I can destroy both of those units, but I can only destroy the skirmisher, which is fine though. So this is kind of at the point of the game where no one has done enough idle damage yet to really make a push to win the game, so we're still trying to clear each other's boards. But the thing is, I have the skirmisher on the field. I have 2 skirmishers on the field, which gives me a pretty big advantage. Vanguard's pretty good, but you always want those relentless guys. So he's just trying to get his stuff on the board, and he gets the skirmisher down. But if I could draw like a flip or something, that'd be really nice for me to get rid of that skirmisher. But unfortunately, I did not. And I'll have to keep on going. And I really should probably be sacking for resources, because I have big card advantage on him, but he has one more resource than me. But now we can start hitting the idols pretty hard if he doesn't do something about it. But if you look at our idols, they're not that high themselves. So we have to be a little bit worried about that. Not too worried, but it could be a problem. So he goes to the POV there. Doesn't really matter. Like, didn't really do anything with the POV. So maybe he was trying to fish for another scroll. here the reversal does come into play. Because then I can use the Roasted Bean God there to kill the Vanguard. So reversal did do well there, but I mean a flip would have done the same thing, but without the cantrip, the card draw though. But reversal was kind of, I think it was really good for those Wings Ward units, so I just wish I used it right there. But for the three cost, it kind of sacrifices some tempo, so I don't know. And now I notice he's going for idols. He used decimation. He wins with two decimations. So I'm just like, I have to win this thing fast. Luckily, I do, as you know. But it got really, really, really tense. Because he just needs to find two decimations. And the whole time I'm thinking, all right, he has two decimations. The reason he rushed there is because he has two decimations left in his deck. And he knows that as long as he protects his house a little bit longer, he's going to win the game. So every turn, I'm just crossing my fingers. See this. People spectating me, this is the ESL order tourney, so it was streamed and everything. Yeah, if ESL's a pretty big deal in the World of Scrolls. They're probably more tense than ranked matches. He is just, I'm just trying to destroy as fast as possible, and he's trying to fish for his last destination. But luckily for me, he does not get it, and that'll be end game for Cashflaw. I feel kind of bad for Cashflaw. He used Faith Duty there. Interesting card to choose in the deck there. Sorry about that, Cashflaw. I tend to knock him out of the ESL tourneys a lot. But now I move on to the quarterfinals. Now they're best of three matches, and I'm facing off versus Devirwi. And I went first, which is awesome in the mirror, as you know. And I've pretty perfect starting hand. I have two skirmish I can get. I have a warder if I need it. So I'm feeling pretty good about this. And then I do sack the warder there because I don't think the warder is that important. I mean, it does protect against pushbacks, pothers, and flips, and even purifications. But I think it's more important to get board advantage with attacking creatures in the order mirror. So that's what I did. There's a reversal, but it doesn't really help right here. Like, if it was, like, a pother or a flip, that would have helped a lot more. But, yeah. So at this point, I know I have the advantage, but he is able to do some big things with that Wings Captain there, which I don't have in the deck, as you know. And I really need, like, a pother or a flip to punish him, but I just don't draw one, which kind of sucks. Especially when he didn't have the water on the same row. Like, this still doesn't have the warder on the same row, but he's able to destroy one of the skirmishers. So he's starting to gain a little bit of advantage. I'm a little worried here. I do have a pretty decent creature hand, but I don't have, like, the Blessing of Haste, flips, pothers, focuses that I need to really come back. And, but luckily that spiky guy's gonna protect me a little bit. But there he moves, the spiky guy. So this is, the game is not looking too well right now. It's really not. But I'm able to get rid of the wing shield finally with a 100% pother. So that's pretty important. I'm really trying to get this first win in this best of three. So I don't have to win both of the next ones to advance to the semifinals. I'm really hoping I get at least one win in the 2014 All-Star Series. But I've actually never gotten a win in an ESL tournament before. I've lost in the finals, I think, three or four times, twice to Blinky in the finals. I'm not good in the finals, I guess. I've lost to PUQ in the finals once or twice, Blinky twice, I lose in the semis a bunch. I can't seem to win the finals, but, so I was hoping for, but we did get to third place here, which is pretty good. And we have two skirmishers out, so now we kind of regained the power in the match with the skirmishers. So it seems like neither of us, neither me or Devere, we had the correct cards to punish each other, because I could have used some flips, he could have used some flips as well. But now we basically clear his board, so I'm feeling very good about this spot. And there's really nothing he can do to come back now. Now that I won the sustained board control and he didn't do enough idle damage. Like you saw last match, after I got the sustained board control, at least Cashflaw was able to deal damage to idles. So he had a chance of winning with a lucky decimation. But, Devirwi doesn't have much of a shot here at winning the game. Because, I mean, my idles aren't low either. and I can just pound him down. So I'm pretty happy about a probable win in game one of the quarterfinals. And you see, every single turn I have an answer for whatever he puts down, because I have scrolls, I have resources, and I have board control. And I'll be able to win very, very soon. So I'm just laying it down, just making sure he has no chance of coming back. And it should be ending next turn, I believe. Yeah, so he's not even really blocking the idols there, and that'll be GG. So now I just need one win of the next two matches versus Davirwi to move on to the semifinals, where I would face Zark. And here, I look at that, three Royal Skirmishers in my hand. This is exciting. I do sacrifice one of them, so next turn I could possibly go with a Royal Skirmisher Blessing of Haste, which is in fact exactly what I do, because Davirwi makes a very risky play, hoping that I don't have any haste on the Skirmisher, and I do, and I get another Skirmisher out. So I look at that board. I have two Skirmishers and a Ducal Infantryman before he had anything on the board. He gets a Skirmisher out himself, but so I move up just in case of like a Roasted Bean Potion, so I don't want him to like Roasted Bean Potion and double focus. And I do have a Transposition, but there's not really much of a point of me using it right here, because I can't even do enough to even kill the Wings Captain. So I'll just pound the idols up there. And if he wants, he could use his captain to make his guys move up. And he actually does do that, and he's able to destroy one of the Skirmishers, which is a nice play by him. But luckily, I am able to draw a Eternal Sword, and I'm getting pretty good draws this turn. And I can kind of punish him for that, but he still has a Skirmisher. We both have a Skirmisher. He uses the Rusty Bean Potion, kills the Aging Knight. I'm not too worried about that. Aging Knight's not that important. I do hate sacrificing Eternal Sword, so I did there for the to keep the Wing Shield, I believe. And that was okay. I was actually almost considering putting in Crown of Strength in this deck instead of Eternal Sword, but as well as Eternal Sword, but I couldn't find a place for it. But I think it'd be pretty good. I know there's pushbacks and purifications, but I was considering. I was also considering Fleetness. But if I had those two cards, I don't think it would have made a difference. I think I still probably would have lost to Zark. Me and Zark will be very close games. And luck factored into his wins, and luck factored into my wins. And, I mean, luck's a big part of all these mirror matches. So, this play right here kind of seals the deal on Davirwi's fate. There goes, like, most of his important board. I have three Skirmishers on the board. He already lost an idol. I'll get a Vanguard. I actually made a misclick there. I meant to sacrifice the focus, not the Blessing of Haste, so I can have the Blessing of Haste on the Vanguard buff everybody next turn. But it doesn't really matter, because I'm going to win this turn anyways. So that's 2-0 me versus Davirwi. So that's, I win the best of three in the quarters, and I move on to the semis, where I see that Zark beat Blinky. Blinky and Zark face in the quarters, so now I'm going to face Zark in the semifinals. Semifinals are also best of three. Everything best of three besides round of 32 and round of 16 are best of 1, and finals are best of 5. So I get the early born advantage, which is awesome, as you've seen every match. And I get, I choose to go for the Royal Spearman, so at least if he attacks it, like, he's dead too. Because the Wing Shield, I do love, but he could always just, like get a focus to kill it. And he does get the first Skirmisher on the board, which, as we know, is very important. But I do have one in my hand, so I'm not too worried. But there's a second Skirmisher. As we know, those are the tickets back into the match. So I'm trying to be very, very, very careful here. I don't want to put my important units, like the Skirmisher, in that lane up a little higher so you can Roasted Bean Potion down. I want to stay far away from him so I can build up my forces down there before I engage. And maybe I can hopefully get a like a flip or something to really turn the tides, or a transposition. But, so, a little worried, he's building up forces, and now he decides to come down initiated battle first, which is pretty fine for me, because I'm able to, actually no, I don't think I really punched him this turn I wasn't able to really do much, because even a transposition wouldn't do a whole lot. But I did decide to move up, and now I'm crossing my fingers he does not have, like, a Blessing of Haste triple focus to punish me. But luckily for me, he did not. And I don't really love having that Eternal Sword and a 4 countdown Aging Knight. He does get rid of the Eternal Sword, but he flips it so it doesn't touch anything else, which is fine by me, because it actually used up his whole turn. He didn't have anything else to play that turn. So that cost him some tempo there. I don't know what he had in his hand. So maybe that was his only play, I don't know. And I have open idols here, so I could do a lot of idle damage, but I decided just to clear his board instead. And that kind of seals the deal for him. Like, I got rid of his Relentless units. He's able to destroy one of my Relentless units, or actually both of my Relentless units. And now he has a Relentless unit, and I don't have a Relentless unit. So I get my Eternal Sword down, and I'm just hitting these idols. I'm feeling okay about this game. I don't think it's, like, in the bag, because he has a Relentless unit and an Eternal Sword unit in front of that. And that's all I did, just to draw the Wing Shield. I'm okay with that. But I really wish I had a Flipper or a Pother here. Or a Reversal. Any kind of those cards would be awesome here, because I would be able to destroy both of those units. But instead, I'm only just going to destroy one of them, and then the Skirmisher gets 5 attack, which kind of sucks. And I separate my guys in different rows so that the Relentless doesn't hurt me more than it needs to. So he's still only going to be able to destroy one unit. Maybe he destroys the Wings Ward too. But so now he definitely has better units on the board than me, but I did have the attacking Spearman there from the Eternal Sword to be able to destroy one of the Skirmishers. And I do get my Pother there, and I'm able to destroy that that Relentless guy. I was really hoping the 1/3 Pother to have it back one so the Eternal Sword wouldn't latch onto anything. But I'll take the Pother anyways, it's fine. And now I have the 6 attack in front of the Vanguard, in front of the Wings Warder. So it's feeling pretty good. He was just trying to Pother to maybe draw something to get him out of trouble, but Frey, he did not, so I'm just going to clear his board here. Well, not exactly, I'll leave that wing soldier up there, but he knows it's over for him, so he surrenders. So I take game one, and I just need to win one of the next two games to move on to the finals, which you guys know that I did. I lost this game and the next game. But as we see, he got a commanding start, and I guess I shouldn't have tried to, like, engage so much, but he got that skirmisher, he has the ducal skirmisher. I'm the Ducal Infantryman, and I'm kind of stuck. I do get my own skirmisher. I'm just praying. I'm just holding on for dear life, but he's putting down units at the same time as me, and I'm not too, I'm not that confident I'll be able to survive this onslaught. My goal is to build up on the sides, and hopefully he doesn't have flips and pothers to really kill my units. And then I'll be able to use my flips and powers to come back in it. That's really my only chance here. And he moves down to engage that crossman, which is fine, but he'll be able to do a bunch of idle damage soon. And my only real shot of coming back in the game is just getting big relentless use, just plow through his rows. So I'm just enchanting my guys. I'm hoping he doesn't have cards to, like, win really soon. But it's a little tough here, and my idols are getting very, very low, but the fact that he damaged idols there, it actually may help me a little bit, because it means I might be able to swoop down there and destroy his units if he's not destroying mine. And I think this is one of the games where it's a little bit of decimation fishing, because here he decides to go all out and destroy an idol. He uses Blessing of Haste, so he gets one idol down. He needs 3 decimations to win, and I'm just like, okay, that's basically he's not gonna be gaining board control, but I'll just have to hope I can win the game before he gets the decimations. And now he needs 1 decimation. That was kind of a probably misplay for me. I should have protected that bottom idol a little better there. but he had the double haste, and I was close to winning that turn, but he had the other destination that he needed, and that was GG. So now this is the third match in the best of three for the semifinals, and I am just hoping I can get this win and move on to the finals, probably get another loss in the finals, because Anti Rad would be there, and he actually made the Iron Order deck I started with. And here, Zark punishes me. It'd be pretty hard to punish, but he would need more than just a busting face, but he gets the busting face and the Ducal Infantryman. So that kind of sucked. And now it's like, I'm just feeling like, okay, that was fast. I just lost the entire game. Look how fast he's going right now. Look at my board and look at his board. I'll just move down. Hopefully I can come back. But sadly, I was not able to avenge Blinky. Zark beat Blinky in the quarters. Zark beats me in the semis. But luckily, Badger came on top and won me that gold in Uxer's vending booth. And gotta root for your guildmates. So, yeah, I'm kind of done. He literally clears my board in this turn. And that's kind of it. I'm not coming back. No point in me wasting both of our time. And these tournaments take, 4 or 5 hours sometimes. So I went ahead and surrendered. And I just had to play for third place versus LeGrand. And he lost his semifinal match like me. He lost his semifinal match to Anti-Rad. So I played him best of three. And I said I won, yeah, so I got third place. And the reason for that is you get a little bit more gold winnings for third. And also, at the end of the five tournaments, points are going to be added up and top four people are going to get exclusive avatar heads, which I really want. And I think, yeah, he actually, best of three, so I could win, I could lose one of these games. And he does have the Relentless Dude with less counts than right now on the board. And he kills my dude. At this point, I don't really play anything because it's just going to die. And then I just see the board right now, and I don't think I'm going to come back from here. So I do a quick surrender. Again, it's only the third place match. It doesn't mean a whole lot, so I just surrender there. And now this match, I'm hoping I can win. I get stuff on the board. But spoiler alert. There is no third match. So I'm going to win this match because I win the entire best of three to get third place. But so I win this pretty normally. I just got a better early curve than him, which is a really win really fast. Like, look at that. It's almost like him last match, besides no Relentless. But he had to go. So he just forfeited the third match, which is not a huge deal. I mean, it doesn't affect the finals or anything. It's just a third place match. So it was a fun ESL tournament. I'm going to try to play in as many of these as I can. I'm probably going to be able to play in all of them. I may not be able to do, I'll always be able to record them. I might not be able to get a video out of the tournament, right after it, though, because I go places and I might not be able to do it, but, hopefully you see me win some tournaments. And you can go sign up yourself. The ESL tournaments are open to all Scrolls players, but if you're new to the game, you're probably not going to do too well because there's a lot of really experienced, strong players in there. So don't fret if you lose. It's a ton of fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed this kind of video. Sorry I went so fast, but I wanted to keep this around 30 minutes. And stay tuned because I'm still doing videos every single day. So keep on scrolling, everybody. Rate the video. Subscribe if you want more content like this. Send your plays in to me for Top Scrolls Plays of the Week. I've been getting some pretty cool submissions. And keep on scrolling. So I will see you all next time.